one of the things that I'm most honored about is that so far, everybody that's attacked me has gone down the tubes. You have Lindsey Graham attacked me. He was at 3%, now he's at 0. You have Perry attacked me, now he's getting out of the race. He was at 4 or 5%, now he's getting out of the race. He was at 0.
Donald Trump isn't entirely wrong. Anyone who goes after him suffers the slings and arrows of a drop in the rankings, which is probably why a certain surgeon has been sneaking up on the well-coiffed one. All well and good, more than a year out from the actual vote. But whether or not Ben Carson has staying power, that is another question with a much deeper need to understand the points at work here. His most recent article in the Daily Caller, one of a series, seeks to set the record straight. Donald Trump on Ben Carson. Doctors don't create jobs. Let's dig into the coming turf war, which might be the mildest one we'll see all campaign long. Welcome Jamie Weinstein to The Hardline. Jamie, thanks for being here. And the first thing that I think when I see this is, and I think about Donald Trump and Ben Carson, is you think about Donald. He's not afraid to attack anybody. He just goes right to the wall on anybody. But I just don't see him doing that against Ben Carson, because what's to attack? The man's so nice and quiet.
Well, I think he gave a little bit of a preview of what his type of attack would be in the interview that I did with him last week. I can tell you that he was reluctant to go there, but I asked him, does he think someone who spent his career as a doctor the experience necessary to be president of the United States? And Trump's answer was that, you know, doctors don't really create jobs. They don't have the executive experience that I have. That is somewhat of a mild attack compared to some of the attacks that he's kind of launched on some of his other opponents. But I think that is the line he would take if Carson ultimately tries to attack him. But Ben Carson's not really that type of candidate going around attacking fellow Republicans.
Did you get any sort of a reticence possibly from Donald Trump? Because not only what you mentioned, the fact he's a doctor, world-renowned neurosurgeon here, but he's also a black candidate, that maybe Donald Trump is a little scared that he's going to start, again, attacking people, but also creating just another rift with the GOP, another rift with voters, and another reason for people not to vote for him.
Well, he certainly was reticent to attack Carson. You know, I don't know if it's because he was afraid to attack the only black candidate in the GOP field, but he certainly wanted to emphasize that Carson he likes Carson a lot. He's met him, somewhat of a friend, if you will. I'm sure not that close of a friend, but friendly relations between the two. So he certainly wasn't anxious to attack Carson. I had to ask a few questions for him to get to the point about, you know, well, doctors don't create jobs. So this is not something I think is going to be a theme for him, unless, of course, Carson attacks him, at which point I think the gloves will be off.
What about Trump himself? Because he mentions executive experience. Got it. Ben Carson has never run a multi-billion dollar industry such as Donald Trump or anybody else. But did you get the sense from Trump that he knew that he doesn't have foreign policy experience, a lot of things that he himself is missing that people can attack him on? But I can only imagine when you ask the question, as I did read some of the articles, that he just started to answer and then he loves to change direction and just misdirect you and go someplace else.
Sure, there's no sense coming from Donald Trump that he lacks any type of experience necessary to Donald Trump. He's number one in everything. So of course not. He did not suggest that he thinks that he needs to bone up on foreign policy. Though you would have to say that, you know, listen to him. Some of the statements he made, for instance, recently on Hugh Hewitt, suggest that he could use to do some of homework on foreign policy. And as he mentioned on Meet the Press, when asked who does he consult for foreign policy expertise to get some advice, he says he watches the cable news shows. You get the sense that maybe going forward, he might try to get some of the people that he says he respects to come in and brief him, like maybe John Bolton or someone along those lines, because certainly he has certain gaps on foreign policy understanding that when he engages someone who really understands what they're talking about foreign policy, you know, come to the fore.
I got about a minute left here, so let me ask this. When it comes down to what I called the misdirection, and you mentioned Hugh Hewitt, it was obvious that Mr. Trump had no idea whom Hugh Hewitt was talking about when he asked the question about the Cuds Force. No idea. And he quickly then misdirected and then quickly blamed him for it almost immediately. Brilliant media strategy if you think about it, though. But did you get that from Trump, that that's the way he works? If he doesn't know, he'll misdirect. He'll come back later. But he's a genius at doing that.
And it's worked so far. I mean, it's amazing. There's been many incidents throughout this campaign on foreign policy and other places where he said things that would normally hurt another candidate, and he's been able to misdirect, deny that he said it, come out and you know, launch a different type of attack and save himself from getting hurt at the polls. So far, that strategy has been tremendously successful. It's no reason to believe that this will change anytime soon.
That had to be just one heck of an interview. God, the one chance to get to sit with Donald Trump. We're going to have to talk about it more. Let me remind everybody that your articles are at thedailycaller.com. It's a series on your interview with Donald Trump. Talks about Ben Carson, talks about the nuclear doctrine, talks about living in the White House. That and so much more. Go to thedailycaller.com and check it out. Jamie Weinstein, thanks so much for joining us. We do appreciate it. And now let's remind you that if you want to learn more about Ben Carson, get your copy of his book, One Nation, absolutely free. Call the number here, 1-800-655-7567, or go to newsmax.com/Ben. Learn more about the man who is indeed putting the pressure on Donald Trump. Stay tuned. The fastest 60 minutes in news continues.